With the launch of AMD's FSR 3.1, everybody now has access to frame generation. So you can have Fidelity FX rub two of your frames together and then like a little baby frame pops out. Pretty sure that's how that works, which is very exciting for budget gamers. But what if you have the potato-iest potato? Now for today's video, we want to see if FSR 3.1 can save the gaming experience of the slowest modern GPU. And I say modern GPU because FSR 3.1 is only available on a couple of brand new games, so the GPU likely needs modern driver support. So we can't just drop like a GT210 in here and call it a day. So we're gonna have to first figure out what the slowest GPU is with modern driver support that I have access to. But luckily, I've got a pretty good idea what it could be. And I think the key word here is GPU, because most dedicated graphics cards that companies still bother to keep updated with drivers aren't that terrible. The same goes for AMD graphics cards. Even something like our reference glue-sniffing slowpoke, the GT710, only gets security updates these days. So I don't think we're gonna be running around as Aloy killing robot dinosaurs with this thing anytime soon, although we will give it a try. Which means we're probably going to use an iGPU, but that iGPU needs to be attached to a CPU that the game will run on. So unfortunately, no 5-year-old Celerons. Luckily, AMD did us a solid by attaching a truly Olympic tier garbage iGPU to their latest 7000 series Ryzen CPUs. But is it really as terrible as I remember it? Well, I guess the best way to find out is just to compare it to an older Intel iGPU. Now, at 1080p low settings in Counter-Strike 2 with the iGPU in our little Ryzen 7600X, we're getting about 20 frames per second, which is by no means usable, but it's quite a bit better than I was expecting. I was expecting a complete meltdown, but this is 1080p and it's kind of running. In fact, I've seen this game run a lot worse, but that would be on like a geriatric Celeron, so it's not the kind of thing that we're gonna be able to run FSR 3.1 games on. Dota 2 at 1080p low settings was also running terribly, although maybe a bit better than expected. But I'm sure when we start running those PS5 ports, this will be exemplary performance in comparison. Now, I decided to pit this iGPU versus the UHD 630, an Intel iGPU, which funnily enough is actually faster than a GT710, but it's still pretty loser grade and will help to put the Ryzen iGPU performance into perspective. Whoa, this is kind of like having your granddad beat you at a 100 meter sprint. Despite its 7-year-old age, the UHD 630 is kind of putting that Ryzen iGPU in its place, at least when it comes to Counter-Strike 2. This humiliation is even more apparent in Dota 2, where the UHD 630 provides a significantly more playable result at 1080p low settings. At which point I decided to drop the GT710 in the Ryzen system just to see how that iGPU compares to our reference sad sack GPU. Whoa, it's real close, but the GT710 manages to edge out the Ryzen iGPU. Being worse than a GT710 is not a position you want to find yourself in, quite frankly, although they are functionally similarly terrible. However, with Dota 2, it didn't feel functionally similar, the GT710 was a bit more playable. But either way, even if one of them was worse than our Ryzen iGPU, Horizon Nondescript Sequel wouldn't launch on either of them, so we're just kinda lucky that the Ryzen iGPU turned out to be the worst one. And with that, it's finally time to see how much FSR 3 can save the performance of our lead-poisoned iGPU. Luckily, Horizon was willing to play ball with our AMD iGPU, so I preemptively set all the graphics settings to 1080p low to see what kind of native gaming performance we'd get from the iGPU. Wow, 3 frames per second, that's very promising. Whoa, this cinematic looks kind of like one of those tech demos they used to launch with graphics cards back in the day to like showcase the new technology, and then the graphics cards could barely run them. This is weirdly nostalgic. It likes that big open scene a lot. Granted, at this point, the little GPU is raw-dogging 1080p, just straight up. But one frame per second really is not very impressive. But my nostalgic wonder quickly started fading when I realized that this game doesn't let you skip cutscenes.
You really can't skip this, huh? They're not gonna let us do that.
Which meant I had to spend what felt like a lifetime watching a slideshow of Horizon Angsty Ginger.
Oh, please let it end.
1 hour later.
Oh, it's been so long, but we're finally at a point where we can try and game, and it's running very well. The input lag is so wild. Oh no, okay, that's not going great. On the bright side, to be positive to it here, the temperatures are good. I think we can see now that the game doesn't run very well. So, let's try... Okay, there we go.
But after a whole bunch of trial and error, I managed to get into the menu and turn on FSR at ultra performance quality, so we can test what that does to the performance before turning on frame generation.
So going with ultra performance FSR 3 has gotten us 2 frames per second. Whoa, that's so wild. It looks so bad now as well. I guess the input lag is slightly more bearable now.
At least we still have frame generation available.
FSR frame generation. Okay, so we've gone from 6 frames per second to 9. Although, that's happened. Oh no, so I think the issue is we've gained a couple of frames per second, maybe, kind of, but I feel like the input lag is as bad as it was without any FSR.
The addition of frame generation made the game feel like I was communicating with my PC on the moon using dial-up. I guess that's why AMD recommends not using frame generation below 60 frames per second. But I have a potential solution.
Unfortunately, FSR 3.1 couldn't save this gaming experience, but we are starting off with 1080p. So let's drop our starting resolution to 800 by 600, but with FSR at ultra quality. Oh yeah, there we go. That is now borderline playable in terms of input lag, although that is just a straight up lie. It still feels terrible, but it's pretty close to almost being kind of usable if we cope hard enough, and the visuals are still amazing. Okay, so maybe this game is a bit too much for this little IGPU. Even though it's rendering at like 3x4 pixels here. So let's try one of the other FSR 3.1 games. Now with some Spider-Man action, our starting point is a lot better than it was with the previous game. It's still really terrible, but it's a marked improvement. So let's drop on some angry Fidelity FX before turning on frame gen. Now, I don't know if you can tell visually, but Fidelity FX is on. This is actually kind of weird. We're using basically half the render resolution, but we're not getting that much more performance. It does feel better though. But I think we need a teeny bit more performance to match the PS5, so let's turn on frame gen. Okay, so we got a bit more frame rate, but again, like with the last game, it introduces a bunch more input lag. So clearly, when the system's already running this terribly, you don't have much input latency leeway. So yeah, the frame gen doesn't really work for this.
And when dropping the starting resolution to 800 by 600, we jump to over 20 frames per second at times. Although the image quality disintegrates to a point where the game's basically just throwing bees in our eyes.
Whoa, all of these games are equally destructive of this little iGPU, my word. Oh, there we go, that's made a huge difference to the performance, and whoa, I get caught off guard every time by how terrible FSR makes it look. Now granted, this is wildly aggressive FSR, so I guess it makes sense.
And when turning on frame gen, it was again the same story, a higher frame rate, but with a lot more input lag, which makes it feel so terrible at this low frame rate. And with that, what did we learn in today's video? Well, I guess AMD was right. You can have two potato a potato for frame gen to work. And with that, thank you for watching. If you enjoyed the video, subscribe to the channel and maybe watch another video. A suggestion will pop up in a second. And until then, bye-bye.